The next bid is a contest between the two people who are going to give the presentation. I asked who was going to give the presentation, and at first it seemed like they were going to duke it out, but the two people who will be presenting for a, move your hands, stop that, Chicago in 2022 bid are Dave McCarty and Helen Montgomery. You definitely don't need to applaud, Dave.
I know where the stage is.
Hello.
Hello. I'm Helen.
I'm Dave.
And we are continuing to look at bidding for Chicago in 2022. We are super excited to inform you that we have gotten some sample artwork from Ray Van Tilburg of Off-World Designs, which emphasizes our theme of not the Hyatt. Finished, so we're not showing it to you yet, but it's like spot on for that theme.
So, but once again, we want to thank you for everybody knowing that we're going to come to Chicago. And in 2022, we, after 108 years in the desert, we will return to Chicago finally again. And we will, of course, be held in the best Worldcon hotel that exists, the Hyatt Regency.
But he's not the Hyatt.
It's totally not.
Take him, Helen. Take him. You should win.
I'm going to fund you a bit. Who's going to pay me to lose?
We all will.
Now to serious.
In all seriousness, so we are starting to talk to hotels in Chicago. And in all seriousness, the Hyatt will be a hotel that we speak to. Because we have to. It is one of the major centers in Chicago. And as all of us know from working with facilities, right, it's important to talk to all of them so that you can find out what all of them are offering and use that to get your best deal somewhere. So we are starting to talk to all of the hotels, and we're going to be moving forward with that in this coming winter slash spring.
A few weeks ago at WindyCon, we had our first sort of tentative organizational meeting to talk to people about joining the bid. But to pre-answer a question, at this point we'd like to announce that how many of our bid members are division head level or above for Worldcon. At this point today, it is 200%. That's how math works. However, many of the people in this room are not going to get out alive. We would like some.
The plan that we have right now is that we'll have another meeting at Capricorn in Chicago in February to talk to folks. We'll be, you know, presenting at the Inquisitions at Worldcon, and then again at SMOFCon in Boston, etc. The official launch of the bid would be in San Jose.
That's where we'll start spending money.
Yeah.
So done.
Done.
We do. So, if you're going to do another Worldcon in Chicago, what did you learn from the last one?
Not the Hyatt.
Actually, I thought you learned that one from the one before that, and it didn't take. So
we weren't involved with that one.
Yeah.
So.
I think we had a really fun time, but there were a few oddball plans that we just didn't quite pull off, and so we've got, you know, screwball plans we want to do next time. So I think it's more of a hope for what's coming next rather than learn from our mistakes sort of thing. If that makes any sense.
Yeah. I think also one of the things that we learned is that at least with the folks we got involved last time, our structure worked really well for us. In terms of chair, vice chairs, division head, area head, staff. And so that worked really well for us last time, but it's not going to be an automatic for this time. We'll certainly look at who we got involved.
So given that for this SMOFCon, we were promised and received a fine downtown hotel facility.
Downtown Rosemont.
So what downtown facilities are you looking at, and how long will it be before you go crawling back to the hive?
is this where we tell them the convention's actually going to be in Colorado Springs?
Yes!
Colorado Springs.
There are a couple of sites downtown. We'll go back and talk to the Hilton and Towers again. But one of the ones that we're probably most interested in looking is, so down at McCormick Place, they are building a Marriott Marquis hotel down there. And there's already a small Hyatt Regency. It's not the Hyatt Regency, it's a small one. It's, in theory, they're nicer. And then there's one other hotel that's been built down there, and I apologize, I can't remember the brand.
But between the set of them, we're up about 2,000 sleeping rooms, so it is a viable site for us.
Yeah, so between those hotels and then McCormick. So that's definitely one of the ones that we're gonna be talking to.
What would you describe as the most impressive aspect of your bid?
At this point, Helen is trembling in fear because she promised me that I could answer this question.
Is your answer what's fun?
No. My answer is Helen. She can fucking do anything.
And we have a couple of extra minutes, so it would be a nice time to even applaud Helen a little bit more because she is also the goddess who's putting on the spotlight.
Are you going to ask us why Chicago? Because we got a good answer for that.
Why Chicago?
Gee, Dave, why Chicago?
Why Chicago? Because you couldn't fit in Carbondale.
Carbondale. No, there's no room in Carbondale. Why Chicago? We one of the things that made us happiest about ChiCon 7 was we introduced a bunch of new to Worldcon Chicago conrunners to things, and you know, we got all these people, and we think that they did a very good job. But unfortunately, we forgot to fucking kill them, and we need to fix that.
Hi, Leanne.
So, at this point, who's actually your bid chair, and who is likely to chair your Worldcon?
The bid chair is sort of is us jointly, and the, who's going to chair the Worldcon is a decision for 3 years from now. If you try to make us fight, we'll fucking kill you.
It's
going to
be me.
Me.
Okay, you said for 3 years from now, right?
Stephen Boucher.
Stephen Boucher, we can read.
I'll throw 20 in for that. It didn't work the last time, but it was so much fun to watch him go, oh my God.
If you throw $20 bills at me, it will be a very fine meal.
I want to watch him eat the 20.
Vegan.
Vegan. Yeah, that's an issue, isn't it? Well, unfortunately not in my country where they're really boring. I don't know if there's anything else.
No, I think we're good.
Yeah, we're good.